Welcome to CEO to CEO training. My name is Doug Fitzgerald. I'm a top, elite, founding, and Star Diamond Team Beachbody coach. And these videos are for Team Beachbody coaches who want to take their businesses to the next level. Now today I want to talk about something that I think is extremely important and will keep you focused as a Team Beachbody coach. You may have heard the term, treat your business like a business. I want to change that up because I don't know if that's the best way to be able to translate the intention of what we mean behind it. I want to change it to treat your business like a job. And let me explain why. Most people in the United States have no idea what it means to be the owner of a business. They have no idea of the time and the work and the effort and concentration and focus that it takes to drive a business. Let's look at maybe your place of employment. The person that owns your business or the people that run your business, what are they going through? Well, if we look at what they go through, they are focused on their business almost 24/7 because they have to make sure, number one, that they have a roof for their company to work with. They have to be constantly creating and developing and improving the product or service that they're providing. They have to provide enough income from the sales of that product or service so that they can pay for rent, they can pay for purchasing things, they can pay for your salary, they can pay for things like health insurance and benefits, and on and on and on. Put yourself in your business owner's shoes right now. I guarantee you that outside of family time and activity, the rest of that time is constantly thinking about how are they going to grow, improve, and keep that business that they have moving forward. It's a 24/7 operation for them. It's a responsibility. It's a strain on them. And because of that, because of the responsibility and all the people that rely upon that business to succeed, they are pushing themselves on a constant basis. And what we want to get across in this whole idea about treat your business like a business, or what I want to say is a job, is that if you want your Team Beachbody business to succeed, you're going to have to drive with incredible intensity to make it succeed at the level you want it to grow at. If you want it to grow at a small level, maybe just taking care of your, you know, enough money to take care of your products, or maybe you want it to pay for your mortgage or pay off your debts, or maybe you want it to be a full-time income. No matter where you are on that spectrum, you're going to have to treat your business like a job to be able to get to that level, whatever that level is. Now, let's change things up a little bit. If you're an employee of a company, what do you have to do to make sure that you keep your job that provides income for you and stability for you and possibly for your family? Well, you got to wake up in the morning. You got to take care of yourself. You got to make sure you get to work on time. While you're at work, you've got to prepare for your job. You got to make sure you do the things that allow you to complete all the things that you're required to complete with your job. And you got to improve yourself in a way if you want to excel at that job. Why? Because you want that income. You need that income. Let's say one day you wake up and you say, you know what, Doug? I'm just not going to go into work today. Not because I'm going to take a vacation day and not because I'm sick. I just decide I'm not going to go into work today. What's going to happen? Well, one of three things are probably going to happen. Number one, you might get reprimanded. Or number two, you might lose some pay in the process. Or number three, you might lose your job. So what do? You make sure you do get to work on time. You make sure you do fulfill the requirements that you are responsible for at your work so that you can keep your job. You see, most people relate to having a job in this country. Very few people relate to owning their own business. I want to teach you right now at the beginning of building your business, or maybe you're in the middle of it, to treat your business like a job. And one day, when the Team Beachbody business takes over for you, then you'll truly know what it means to treat your business like a business. So I would like to give you some action steps to follow today that can help you stay intense in growing and developing your business. Now, one of the things that I need you to do right away is you need to go into your online office and print off two forms. The first one is the three vital behaviors form. You need to have this because it talks about the foundation of building your business. The second one is the business activity tracker. A lot of people call this the BAT for short, but it refers to the business activity tracker. And this gives you specific steps to follow every single day to build your business. So, what are some action steps that you need to take to make sure that you are intense in building and developing your business? Well, number one, the three vital behaviors they tell us exactly how we need to lay the foundation for the work of our business, which is number one, invite. You have to constantly invite people to hear about the business, hear about the products, inviting them to challenge groups and fit clubs and opportunity presentations and local events and national events and calls. Invite is a foundation of how you get people interested in your business. The second thing that's important in your vital behaviors is being proof that the product works. You see, if you are out there sharing about our business and our products and you're not living by it, then why in the world would somebody want to join you in this business? You've got to be, you know, doing your workouts, drinking Shakeology on a daily basis, and being a proof that the product works. And the third thing with the three vital behaviors is personal development. I believe personal development is so extremely important to not only your business growth, but when you grow personally, it affects every other aspect of your life. And I'm telling you right now, if you will make personal development a regular activity, daily activity in your life, it will reap huge rewards for you for years and years and years to come. So, what do you need to do specifically? That's when we move on to the business activity tracker. Now, before I jump into this, I need to tell you a couple things. First of all, I think it's extremely important to set goals. You need to set daily goals, weekly goals, monthly goals, and annual goals. I encourage my team members to dream big. Big, crazy goals. What would you like to achieve with this business? Maybe you want an incredible home. Maybe you want a car. You want to pay off debt. You want to pay off your mortgage. Maybe you want it to be something that allows you to do this business full time. Whatever that is, put those goals out there and then start refining those goals and come up with a few goals each year that you're going to achieve that will really help you in a vital way achieve what you want to achieve with this business. Write down your goals. And there are many, many different ways and systems out there that you can go through a goal setting process. Go to your upline, go into your online office and ask for different ways, different systems to help you achieve your goals. The second thing before we jump into this is you need to schedule your business time. If this is gonna, you know, if you're gonna treat this business like a job, then you gotta schedule your time. And make sure you schedule your time specifically in your calendar weeks, months in advance, okay? So that you know exactly what days and what times you're gonna work your business. Now, what if you decide that you're gonna work your business Monday through Friday from 7 o'clock until 9 p.m. in the evening? And you're gonna do that Monday through Friday. But one week you decide, well, I'm not gonna do it on Tuesday and I'm not gonna do it on Friday. I just don't feel like it. I just don't know if I can do that day. What's gonna happen? Well, if you treat your business like a job, you need to understand, you're gonna get back what you put into this business. You're gonna lose sales, you're gonna lose commissions. Well, you won't get reprimanded, but you may drift into a state of wondering why you're in this business to begin with, and you may lose that desire as well. So you need to schedule your time, and you need to stick to that schedule. Now, let me give you a little tip, a little golden nugget that I like to share with my team, because every time I talk about this with coaches, it seems like I always get moms who will say, but Doug, I want to share with something that's really deep in my heart. I just feel guilty if I take that time away from my family. I feel guilty if I take that time away from my kids. And I don't want to do that. I don't want to take that time and feel guilty. Well, let me give you a little tidbit of information. Let me give you a little tip that I think will really help you if you're moms or if you're dads as well, okay, is this. Schedule your time. Maybe you're going to have your time that you're going to work the business from 7 to 9 p.m. at night, okay? And then let your family know. Sit down with your family, with your spouse, with your kids, and say, listen, this Team Beachbody business is extremely important to me. So important that I'm going to schedule time every day to make sure that it grows because I have goals and dreams that I want to achieve that will help all of us in this family. So I want to work my business from 7 to 9 p.m. Now, from the time that you get off school at 3 o'clock until, you know, 7 o'clock, I'm yours. That's you and me time. You know, we're going to have dinner together. We're going to do all the things we need to do, homework. We're going to, you know, go run errands, whatever it is. But from 7 to 9, I would love for you to respect my time so that I can build the business. From 9 o'clock on, when I'm done, I'm yours again. What that'll do is it'll set boundaries and it'll let the people in your life that are important know that they're important and that you set them as a priority. And you're not going to let that time ooze over into their time. And by the way, don't do that. If you say 7 to 9, keep it 7 to 9. If you say 7 to 8, keep it 7 to 8. When 8 o'clock comes, you're done and you're spending time with your family, okay? And don't do it early either if you commit that. So just a little tidbit of information that'll help. Okay, let's run through this business activity tracker. And if you don't have one in front of you, again, I encourage you to download it. What are some things that you're gonna have to do every single day or throughout the week, hopefully every single day or most days, to be successful in this business? Number one, being proof the product works. Schedule your workouts, drink Shakeology. Make sure you're doing that on a regular basis. Secondly, we talked about personal development. Make sure you're reading 10 pages of a good book every day or listening to 10 to 15 minutes of a good audio or more a day to help you in your personal development growth. Stay current. Make sure that you're always in your online office. Make sure you're listening to the National Coach Call. Make sure that you're current on all of the information, the news, the incentives, the new products that are coming out, so that you're an expert in this business and your coaches and your customers see you that way. The next thing is social media. Make sure in some way that you're plugged into social media, okay? Find out. There's all different kinds of resources we have in the online office to learn about that. But social media is so big and so huge, it's a great way to build your business. Make sure that when you're doing social media, that you're doing at least maybe 2, 3, 4 posts a day. Post it, encourage other people, get the information out to other people, show them that you're a real person and sharing with them your real life. And then also promoting products and maybe challenge groups and other things that can help them, ultimately helping you build your business. New contacts. I believe you need to be making between 2 and 5 brand new contacts for both the products and the business every single day. If you do that, you will have a constant flow of people coming into your business. The next one is invite people to a challenge group. If you've never set up a challenge group, I encourage you to do that. If you set up a challenge group, then make sure that you participate with that challenge group throughout the week. The next one is invite people to learn about the business. All of these contacts that you have, all of these people that you run into every day, the cool thing about this BAT is that you can keep track of them. It gives you a space right down here to keep track of all the people that you're making contact with. And in inviting people to hear about the business, there are various ways to do that. You can send them the Introducing Team Beachbody video. You can send them to webinars. You can bring them to local meetings and to local presentations. You can do all different kinds of things to invite them to the business presentation. The next one is follow-up. Make sure that if you get any communication from your coaches, from your customers, from prospective coaches or customers, that you follow up with them immediately or as soon as you can. How about the existing customers that you have? If you have existing customers, make it part of your regular routine to contact them in some way. I make sure that once a month I send a newsletter to all of my customers. You know, and then on a regular basis, every once in a while, I'll send an e-card from the back office to them. But I'm also, finding different ways to communicate with them on a regular basis. Make sure you're doing that too. And the final thing is connect with your team. If you've got a team of coaches, you need to be communicating with them at least twice a week, whether it's through team calls, whether it's through, different types of business challenge groups that you have, whether it's through texting, group emails, whatever it might be. Make sure that you're communicating with them at least twice a week. And these are just some basic things. I know coaches who are extremely successful in this business. They're top coaches, they're elite coaches. They're making, full-time incomes from this. And this is just the basics that they do. This is just the mere foundation. They want to take their business to a whole nother level, and they do a lot more than just these things. If you want to learn about that, then I would encourage you to contact the elite and top coaches. I would encourage you, when you're at events, to pull them aside and pick their brain a little bit about how they've gotten to the level that they've gotten to. Well, I hope this has been helpful to you. Most people say treat your business like a business, but I'm going to say treat your business like a job. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on our next CEO to CEO training.